Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to talk about Power BI release January 2023. And this is not going to be for Power BI Cloud. This is all about Power BI for Report Server. Basically, like in case of Report Server, Power BI Report Server, it contains a release cycle like 3 times in a year. And this is the first release for 2023. And the other 2 release happens on May and followed by September of every month. With this note, let's jump into today's topic. And before viewing it, this channel contains free content worth $1,000 to $50 or 100,000 INR. So utilize this free content that covers Power BI, MSBI, SQL, and basics of Azure. Let's jump into today's topic. So Power BI, as I mentioned before, Power BI Report Server Jan 2023, and it doesn't contain most of the updates because mostly they amend whatever they did it in the cloud for last 3 months or previous quarters into the report server. Not all the features, but only those features which is core features that are missing as part of the Power BI development. So in this, like they amended like accent color update, and this is the feature I like the most, like RDL and Power BI file migration. Basically what they did is like they have a new tool to migrate RDL reports to Power BI services. You can see it from here. So those who already have the RDL, basically they develop in SSRS, they can migrate it to Power BI file. That is the core update about this release. Then you might have seen this in the Power BI Cloud future releases in previous months. Reverse stack order for stacked column charts. As I said before, it will be like amendment of those releases that happened previously. So this feature is being amended in this release. Then pushing top end filters to direct query sources. This is also very important. Those who are actually working in the Power BI report server, they're waiting for such a features which is already available in desktop for cloud. So now this feature is available, like pushing top end filters to the direct query sources is possible now. Then other important aspect is like modeling feature. This is something those who are developing that will be very useful for them. So DAX formula bar support for desktop model view, and the introduction of the new DAX function. It is actually not new. This is already released in previous release. Evaluate and log, which logs the whatever evaluation happened. Along with this function, there is helper function to CSV and to JSON. So these two very similar DAX function closely related to evaluate and log, but can also separately, this function convert input table to CSV or JSON. As the name indicates, it's going to convert your input table into CSV or to JSON. So another functions amended in this release is like index, offset and windows. So I am going to make a separate video on this sooner or later about this DAX function. So in the Power BI release January 2023, then these three functions are useful when you do the comparison. I hope there is not much about this release other than most of the things are amended here as part of a previous release that happened in the cloud in the Power BI report server. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.